tonight, a major win for the state's bikies, with laws designed to break up gangs thrown out by the highest court in the land.
TEN's crime reporter Matt Doran is at State Parliament. Now, Matt, this is a major blow to police and the government.
And Bill, perhaps a psychological setback as much as it is a legal one. The High Court ruling leaves the government in an embarrassing and, in fact, almost surreal scenario. To the Hells Angels, the outlaw gang on which we spend so much money chasing justice, the government must now hand over a cheque for legal costs running into the hundreds of thousands of dollars. And that fact has prompted some very wide grins on the faces of bikies right across the country. Now, police and the Attorney General, normally very vocal on this subject, today they went to ground pending an examination of the High Court ruling. In essence, the court found that these laws are just invalid and in fact infringe on the implied constitutional freedom of political association.
From the highest court in Australia, a green light for bikies to ride free. The victory belongs specifically to the Hells Angels, but gangs across Australia spent the day celebrating.
They were very excited. Very, very excited, because they understand the implications of this. It should have been stopped in its infancy rather than let go this far, with the enormous cost implications to everybody.
Most acutely, taxpayers. The High Court has ordered the New South Wales government foot the Hells Angels' legal costs of hundreds of thousands of dollars. The anti-bikie laws were introduced after a fatal brawl between the Comancheros and Hells Angels at Sydney Airport 2 years ago. The laws aimed to prevent gang members even associating, but critics say they threatened the integrity of the Supreme Court.
We should all be celebrating that our human rights have been protected. They couldn't even send each other a birthday card. They couldn't even have a drink together on Christmas Day.
The club comprises of a number of father and sons, brothers, cousins. So it would have wrecked a number of families. It would have prevented them from working in certain occupations.
The verdict deals a monster blow to the besieged New South Wales gang squad. In its first year, Strike Force Raptor laid 1,500 charges and seized almost 4,000 rounds of ammunition, along with $1 million in cash.
It's too early to prepare celebrations. I'm told that they'll be organised in the next couple of days. But for the moment, I'm just having a cup of coffee with my son.
The government says a return to the High Court is likely. Matt Doran, 10 News.